Thank you. Later in the service, we're going to have a time of special prayer. As you can see, we have a lot of opportunities for people to sit. A number of our folks are just not feeling good today. Winter weather's finally given us a little break, and I guess their bodies are just wore out from trying to survive the deathly cold. So we want to be able to pray for a number of those who are not able to be here today because they're sick. We have mid-retreat coming up. Dun, 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 dun. Some of you have asked, where's the sign-up sheet? Well, I'm glad you asked. It is right inside of this 2015 mid-retreat at Anderson Farms brochure. On the inside flap, you'll find your sign-up sheet. All you need to do is fill this out, tear it off, give it to either Gene Prophet or myself, and put your payment of $45 in the offering box. I want to encourage you, because every year someone doesn't do this, and it drives the business manager crazy. When you put your $45 in the offering box, please mark on the envelope, Men's Retreat, because we will use your money for something. But it will not be Men's Retreat unless you mark Men's Retreat on it. Now, thankfully, the business managers are far more Christian than I am. So every year when someone has done this, they have reallocated it to the right department. Whereas I would have said, hey, the Lord gives, the Lord takes away. Go another 45. So you can either hope for the best with Pastor Joyce getting it in the right place, or you can just do it right for her and put on their Men's Retreat. $45 is coming up in April. If you've not been to one of these, it's because you're not a man. Not allowed to go. My favorite part of Men's Retreat is twofold. One, sitting around the fire with a cup of coffee. And two, no shaving. It is a no-shave zone. You're not allowed to shave. And I just live for days like that. So if you want that information, it's on the back table. This Friday night, you have the opportunity to do a couple of things. One, have a good time. Just a quick show of hands. How many of you are in favor of enjoying yourself? About half. Okay, yeah, that's Christians for you. The other half, no, that's not godly. I will not have fun in Jesus' name. And when we get to heaven, if they're enjoying it, I will put a stop to that. For the rest of you who are okay with having fun, you're going to want to be a part of this on Friday night. Because we're going to get to go to First Fruits this Friday night. And it is fun. If you've ever been on the van on the way there or back, it's just a good time. We're going to go for a special reason. We're going to have a communion service with them. The men and women at First Fruits don't get to have very many communion services. It's just not part of what they do. And so Pastor Dick and Jonathan from First Fruits have put this together. We're going to have worship together. We're going to have communion together. We're going to be able to watch God do some amazing things in the lives of these men and women. If you're able to go, we want you to go. It starts at 7 o'clock. You have two options. You can either meet us there at 7 o'clock, or you can ride with us on the church van. Because of traffic, we have to leave at 5:30 on Friday. And so if you're looking for a reason to get out of work early, you want to blame God, this is it. Just have to go. I'm on a mission for Jesus. Now, if you leave at 10 a.m. from work, I don't know what you're doing in the meantime, but don't blame God, okay? We're going to leave at 5:30. If you want to make sure you've got a seat on the van, check with Colleen. She'll put your name on the list so we're able to be there. Then Saturday, ladies, this is your opportunity. You're having another ladies' event. It's going to be at Barb Jones' home. It's going to start at 11. It's going to include food and dessert. And dessert is not food. Food is something you need to survive. Dessert is God's gift to humanity. So we have food and dessert. And they have a wonderful opportunity to look at some neat items that they're doing there. It starts at 11 o'clock Friday. Do not bring dessert. Don Manfrey is providing dessert for everyone. But do bring some food. I mean, it's a potluck style. We were in a church years ago. Ladies passed away, so I'm trying to say this in public without getting in trouble with her. They were a very well-to-do family. And They always pretended like they were broke. Anybody know somebody like that? Alright. We would have potlucks and tons of food and just a wonderful time. The gymnasium would be packed with stuff. Every single potluck. Every single potluck. Now again, she didn't miss a potluck. Her plate looked like she was a pastor. It was loaded down. She walked by faith that that plate would be able to hold the contents of it. Her donation, every single time, was one can of corn. Not even open.
Thank you. That's not pretty good.
Thank you.
just a little bit. Tim's going to lead us in that last song one more time. I want to give you an opportunity for our pastors to pray with you. You and I are on the receiving end of God's goodness. I know you feel obligated to say yes, even though I haven't given you a reason why yet, because it just sounds spiritual. But let me give you a reason why, and then you can say yes as well. We are on the receiving end of God's blessings because of the pastoral team the Lord has given to us. Pastor Stephen, Pastor Joyce, who not only are both licensed ministers, but are a married couple who actually like each other. You talk about the power of God at work. We have our newest member, Pastor Dave Barnhart, who this afternoon is going to be not only a family friend, but a representative of Jesus Christ for a funeral for individual 24. Pastor May because of drug addiction. Yet God has called him and equipped him with the gifts that he needs, not just to represent God this afternoon, but does a great job here as well, working diligently toward his counseling degree so God can continue to use him. And his biggest focus is outside the church walls. He knows you and I have lots of people we can call. Whether we do or not, another issue, but we have lots of people we know. You'd be surprised how many people outside the churches don't have anybody to call. Because the advice they get is, well, let's go get drunk. Then the problem is, not only do you still have the same problem you got drunk, but now you're broke. And you don't feel good. So they need someone who speaks their language, somebody who is appointed by God with that relaxed personality that's very approachable, but also with the gifts and talents that we need to help them. That's what Pastor did. And of course, Pastor did our shortest member of the team. Quiet and shy and reserved. Many of you probably haven't even met him yet. Always in the back. Gifted teacher. Make sure that all our ministries are run properly. Allows me to run around looking for good places because he's actually doing all the hard work to make sure that everyone else has what they need. I'm often amazed the size of our congregation and the number of pastors God's given. I give two answers to people who ask me. One answer that I give is, well, if you had met me, if you knew me, you'd see why God had put so many others there, since you could say no one. The other is because God is preparing us for something more than one. He's laying the foundations for what is to come. One of our pastors is homesick today because he needs prayer. His wife's here. She's the one we like anyway. I only say that because I'm always watching from his bed. But I'm going to ask them to pray for him. We're going to do a little, I keep saying differently, there is no normal here where we do prayer. So we're going to do normal. A couple of our pastors are loud and express. A couple are like I am. Quiet, reserved. And so when they're praying for you, you may not hear them because they may not pray out loud. That's okay, they're not actually talking to you. They're going to be talking to God. And I'm going to ask you not to talk to them. Because the problem with friends is when you start talking, it never stops. And That's a good thing unless you're needing to get something done. So here's what we're going to do. Just a minute. Tim is going to play just as I taught him. All those great skills. If you would like the Lord to do something in your life, through your life, if you have a prayer request, I'm going to ask that you simply just raise your hand. One of these pastors will come around to you, and they'll either take you by the hand, put your hand on your shoulder, depending on where you're sitting, and they're just going to ask God. They're not going to ask you what we're praying about. You're not going to tell them what we're praying about. There's a difference. They may pray in English. They may pray silently. They may pray in tongues. They may do all three. But they're going to come to you. This is the Lord who called the elders of the church. You're going to give them a call with the raising of your hand. They're going to come to you. And God is going to do something on your behalf. Are you ready? Tim's going to play. Those of you who aren't praying are going to sing. And then we're going to watch God do miracles.
Thank you.
They prayed for you, and Pastor Dick asked that we pray for Otis and Bonnie, so that's what we're doing. I want to give you a chance to pray for them. And you're getting off easy because there's only three instead of four. So I'm going to ask our pastor to just stand here at the middle aisle anytime soon. Only thing worse than one pastor is a group of them, because no pastor listens to anybody. And I want to give you a chance. Come gather around them. Put your hands on their shoulders or on the shoulder of whoever got there before you. And just begin to ask God for blessing. Blessing in their finances, blessing in their marriages, blessing in their opportunities. Every area that needs to be reached by God, we want you to do. Pastor Dave, I know you're the only one to listen. Others who refuse to participate. It's just easier that way. A room full of leaders is like trying to push a string on a straight line. And those of you who are baptized in the Holy Spirit and have the gift of speaking in tongues, feel free to just use that gift as you pray to the Lord. Nobody's going to lead you. Just go and ask God for blessings and miracles. The things that come to your mind are the things that God put it on your heart to ask for them. So let's do that.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Come be out there and see you.
Thank you. Morning, everyone. I'm reading from 1 Thessalonians 2, 17 to 20. Right, the brothers, when they were torn away from you for a short time, in person, not thought, out of our intense longing, we made every effort to see you. For we wanted to come to you, certainly I, Paul did, and again, but Satan stopped us. For what is our hope, our joy, or the crown in which we will glory in the presence of our Lord Jesus, when he comes? Is it not you? Indeed, you are our glory and joy.
Great smile, always happy and helpful. I just wish I